see you. Let's take a look there. All right. Well,
so good of you to see me.
Well, listen, pleased to see you. Pick up the chair right over there. I think it's still warm.
That's fine. You're on my good ear.
I could have to tell you about these things.
Dr. House says I got reports from Dr. House about your
he says it won't work for you, Caesar.
Well, they've been trying to sell me these, but they keep dropping out of my ear, and I just don't seem to work.
Oh, golly. Stay in. Now there's a whole new gimmick, you know.
He showed me that,
you know?
Yeah.
You shut it off if you want to talk on the phone. You just push a little button. And
he also shuts it off sometimes when we're talking.
Oh.
Well,
have you seen the round? He brought me up the round thing. If you're just a regular telephone or something, you clamp this on and it amplifies the hearing. So that you can just a plain phone or phone on the road or something.
Yeah.
But it's kind of hard to carry in your back pocket.
Yes.
They've been really running me.
Not a little green. No green on any of them.
Oh, goodness. It's two layers of it.
We're all ready.
All right. Yeah. I don't remember you knelt for me.
Right.
I bless you.
Yeah, I'm standing.
Mr. Ambassador.
Mr. President, happy St. Patrick's Day.
Well, happy St. Patrick's Day to you.
See ya.
It's a pleasure to see you here.
And Minister Flynn?
Sir.
Yes. Happy St. Patrick's Day. We are three of them.
Appreciate it
very much.
And Councillor Burke.
Nice to meet you, Mr. President. Good to see you. Who?
Top of the morning to you, Mr. President. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Thrilled with everything.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Oh, they treated me beautifully over there. You'll have to come back.
I'd like to. Well, you better get a little closer.
Oh, well, I'd love to. I don't mind that.
Would
you like to present something? You have to.
President, on behalf of the people and the government of Ireland, we would like to present you the symbol of the Irish people, shamrock, all the way from now.
Well, thank you very much. That's the real thing.
It's the real thing. And all the way.
So glamorized.
In a waterfront cut glass. Maybe stuff to you.
Well, thank you very much. You're very kind.
You said it on all our behalf.
Well, you know, this is a great day. In our own country here, for so many of us who have a background of Irish heritage, I think that even more than that on St. Patrick's Day, I think the population of the Irish in the world multiplies quite considerably.
All the time. Yes, you do.
Yes.
Quite a lot of them are here with me. So you have a special interest for us. We have one or two other small
ones. Yeah, I'll see one of those.
This one in particular, I want you to see. Replica of a Viking sword.
And it means you had a bit of a wound somewhere.
7th century.
Oh, then.
Made for you. Made especially in the others for you. And it's an exact replica of the Vikings used when they came to our country in the 7th century.
Well, thank you very much. That was magnificent.
That's lovely. Get it back.
I didn't think about that.
24.
Yes, that's wonderful.
Okay. Our pleasure. And finally, we have to show you the process.
Another special.
Especially for the millennium, $1,000 six more, three strikers, three of them are bank.
Here's the 1,000th year.
1,000 years in Dublin.
Dublin, the city of Dublin.
988. Is that amazing?
Thank you.
Yes. You have a great year for a visit, Mr. President.
They're especially here.
Well, yes.
The people of Dublin.
Oh,
well,
yes.
Thank you very much.
It's magnificent.
Well, this is just wonderful.
I'm sure
you know how much everyone here on the side feels about still living together and settling, and now this latest tragedy.
Thank you.
That's not to say that you haven't done your best. We want you to know it's appreciated, everything you've done in your time.
Well, we shall continue to try.
So you don't know the affection you're having. I want to bring that
very true.
It is true.
Thank you. It is true.
Yeah.
I want to express it to you.
Thank you.
Indeed. It's a pleasure to be with you today.
Yeah.
Well, this has been just wonderful.
You're the magnificent shamrock.
This was a present to me a few days ago, so I put that on for today.
Yeah.
Good. Then I came down and I saw. I have to pass by the White House doctor's office, and one of the nurses there, Joan, is Irish, and she had that for me.
Good for you.
Leave it just two little personal thoughts on my part. Nothing much, one for you, one for Nancy.
Well, thank you very much.
I have to give you a little touch of the Irish, too. You know that.
Yes.
And we are celebrating on November 19th the first intercollegiate football game played outside of America. For credit, a valid game, Boston College against West Point. And I would love to see you there. You'd love the game from your old days.
When is this?
It's November 19th. It might be just the time for a little swing around the world, or that part of the world, Mr. President.
Yes.
I'd love to have you come over.
You don't really know that.
I know.
A lot of people coming from
you.
Just
much.
A thought. Nothing much.
Mr. President, a lot of people coming from America this year to celebrate with us the millennium.
That's
in
it.
Dublin. And that game has especially put on, I understand, 10,000 Americans are actually coming over.
Charted 47 jumbo jets. They said, well, do you think the president might come? I said, well, I certainly will be sure he understands. He's welcome and, in fact, very warmly invited. So we know how busy you are, Mr. President, but something to keep in the back of your mind. After all those other important things are handled.
Yes.
Now, if the president ever comes back to him, he's going to come to my constituency, to Ashford Castle.
Right. Yes.
Yes, I was there.
You enjoyed that?
Yes.
Nice, lovely place.
Mm-hmm.
My first visit ever to Ireland, though, I will always remember being on Cashel Rock.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And the young guide who was showing us around took us through the old cemetery and then showed us that ancient tomb. With the inscription on the tomb, remember me as you pass by, for as you are, so once was I. But as I am, you too will be, so be content to follow me. And that had proven too much for some visitor who had scratched underneath to follow you. I am content. I wish I knew which way you went.
well said indeed. Indeed, we can. I remember you well when you came and addressed both houses of Parliament. I was there that day.
Well,
when you.
three songs we can all sing along this year. Called The Whistling Gypsy. Whiskey in the jar, one. So we sing in the chorus, Wish a ring of a doodum da, one, two, three, four. Whack for the daddy o, one, two. This whiskey in the jar, one. Are you from County Derry, you would say one. Here we go with the chorus.
Wish a ring the doodum da, one, two, three, four. Whack for the daddy o, whack for the daddy o, this whiskey in the jar, one.
You weren't loud enough, now you're going to have to do better than that, God Almighty. We sing in the chorus, Wish a ring on the doodum da, one, two, three, four. Whack for the daddy o, one, two. This whiskey in the jar, one. Okay, here we go again.
Wish a ring the doodum da, whack for the daddy o, whack for the daddy ho, this whiskey in the jar.
Lovely, here we go.
As I was going over the barfing heavy mountain, I met with Captain Cullen, and my ear was crunking. I first produced my booker, then produced my pistol. James, hand down the door for you, are my bold receiver. I shall ring the doodum da, back for the daddy ho, back for the daddy ho, this whiskey in the jar.
much. Here's a little song we can do. We sing along song here because you're all in a singing mood here. It's a little song called The Wild Rover. And in the chorus, it's very easy. It's something like the whiskey in the jar there. And we clap our hands again and we go, and it's no, nay, never. You go, one, two, three, four. No, nay, never, no more. One, two. And they play The Wild Rover. One, no, never, no more. Not at least for another. At least for another. 9, 10 hours. Then they can play The Wild Rover in 10 hours. Now here's the chorus now. Let's really sing it. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more. Will I play The Wild Rover? No, never, no more. Didn't he is singing out at all? Let me give you the chorus again. And it's no, nay, never. One, two, three, four. No, nay, never, no more. One, two. Will I play The Wild Rover? One. No, never, no more. And it's no, nay, never. Tunes here with the whistles, and we'll do the man doing the whistle here. Couple little jigs this time. The first one's called Banish Misfortune, the second one's called Bill Hearts. Jesse is clapping along here, James. Thank you.
Arizona. I used to frequent, and I told Janet my money was spent. I asked her for credit. She answered me, "Such a question for yours, I." We're going to see all of you people sing it, and sing it better than the rest of the people here. All right, let's do it. And it's no!
Yeah. and that's another. So sure that you're born, the loveliest of all of the unicorn.
So to say something here, and first of all, a very great thank you to Pat Troy, the owner of this particular place. James, Jack Kilpatrick, and I. This has been a very happy surprise. I just thought we were coming over here for a St. Patrick's Day lunch. It was quite a surprise, but a very pleasant surprise. You know, my father told me when I was that high that the Irish built the jails in this country and then filled them. You're thinking what I did, and for a long time I was very chary about saying anything. I didn't know why he was so proud of that. Until I got a ticket once from a Chicago cop. Heard that brogue, I found out what he meant. The police forces of America are largely Irish. So by now I can tell you I've got a pub named after me in Ballyporeen. But I just want you to know I'm very leery about ethnic jokes now in my position. So the only ones I can tell are Irish. Well, no, I really set out to tell you that on that same trip to Ballyporeen where I found that pub, I went up on Cashel Rock later, where St. Patrick erected the first cross in Ireland. And the young Irish guide who was showing me around took me through the cemetery, and he stopped me by one very ancient, large tombstone there. And the inscription on the tombstone read, "Remember me as you pass by. For as you are, so once was I. And as I am, you too will be. So be content to follow me." And that was too much for some Irishman of more recent vintage who had scratched underneath, "To follow you, I am content. I wish I knew which way you went." Find this place 7 years ago.
That's because you were in the Airy pub in Boston, that's why. Yeah. Can't keep out of the damn places, can you?
No, it's those people over there that tell me where I'm going every day. Well, again, thank you very much, and thank all of you. God bless you.
Thank you.
Listen, thank you very much for being in your administration. It's been a little over 4 years now for me, and it's been a pleasure serving you. And I know all of us, it's been a real privilege to be in Washington in this administration. We're really proud of you.
And thank you for all you've done
and all the,
for all your help.
All the things. We brought an Irishman to get a picture with you, so that's right.
Well, I think you want to square around here.
Always
on the same one.
You want to get,
in the middle? And then why don't one of you come over on this side?
Yeah. Right, well,
there, that family picture, and I got myself in the family.
Scrunching a little bit closer, man. Okay. Let's do one more. Did it flash?
No, I didn't. It hasn't flashed at all, I don't believe.
Okay.
We were so concerned with all the things that were going on that you might not have time.
There.
Yeah.
Okay. There it flashed.
Thank you.
Wait 1 second here. A few little souvenirs to take on your way.
Thank you.
Pin. Thank you so much.
For the boys' key rings with the seal. Oh.
Thank you.
And a souvenir.
Well, listen, thank you very much. What a pleasure to be with you.
Well, listen, I wish you all the
good luck in the next 6 months. You know, we want you to go out with a big splash.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Thanks. Okay. Ken. I'll give you a holler. It'll be in about 5-10 minutes. Okay.
Okay, Mr. President. Got good news on that Cochran. He's going to be with us on the override on Boat Patrol City.
Oh.
Mr. President, let me introduce Mrs. Lucy Ball-Owsley.
Yes, hello.
Mr. President, wonderful, wonderful.
Well.
I heard you last evening in your wonderful speech. And I think I converted a Mexican friend who was here in the UNESCO, and she was very, very much impressed.
Well, listen, I know the support that you've been, not only me, but the entire party and all. I'm very pleased and proud.
Well, and at the request of the Taoiseach, the Prime Minister of the of Ireland, I have been given the honor of presenting you with a tape of the President's U.S. Marine Band.
Well.
And, thank you.
Well, I remember.
Which band you so generously sent over to Dublin, Ireland.
Yes.
In the concert hall.
Yes,
and,
for Margaret Heckler.
Yes.
Well, she's here today with some of the officials because of the day that
he and March 17th is to be your last St. Patrick's Day in the White House.
Yes.
And I wish you and your lovely Nancy all the luck of the Irish, wherever you may roam.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, this
I'm
is
David
your son,
Alexander.
David.
Yes. The honor of being her son. Nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to see you.
And Christina Rostow, my mother's companion.
Nice to see you.
President Donald Dunham from the Irish Ambassador.
Yes.
Great honor.
Yes.
And a happy St. Patrick's Day to you.
I didn't agree with your indeed. Quite a bit earlier.
Yes. I have a book that I wonder if lovely Mrs. Reagan would like. It's is a true story of an American woman who married an Iranian, and she was not going to leave the country, not without my daughter, and I thought she might enjoy reading it.
Oh. You love it. Well, thank you very
these
much.
These are some lessons for
you. Well, thank you.
We didn't get a group photo, Mr. President.
Oh, yes,
that'd be good.
A group
photograph.
Why don't I?
Photograph again?
There we go.
There we go.
Why don't you? I'll stand behind.
Then.
Let's
have somebody to run.
This is a
North
Carolina. Shall I get over here?
On the other side of the road.
There we go.
Scrunch in.
Okay.
That's good. wonderfully.
That's okay. Kind of your decision.
Well,
thank
pleased
you.
To see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And my little girl is thinking about you all the time.
Well, give her my regards.
She really loves you.